Starting off with a plain black maxi skirt or any other solid colored skirt. This is made up of one of those weird rayon cotton hybrid that makes you sweat but refuses to absorb any of that sweat. Anyway, when finding a top to pair with such a skirt, go for one with a different texture. Maybe lace. I use a lace crop top just to add some detail to the entire outfit. I put a pair of wedges underneath my skirt because it's hidden, and why not take the advantage of adding some inches to my 5'3" self. You can't expect this to be one of my outfit videos without some weird dancing, so I warned you. Going from a maxi to a miniskirt, I guess this wouldn't be called a miniskirt in many different cultures, but in India this would classify as downright scandalous, so hooray to that! The yellow in the skirt is matched by the yellow in the heels and the yellow spots in the skirt. It's a perfect spring slash summer slash monsoon slash whatever season this is supposed to be outfit. Time is frozen in lockdown and therefore so is the earth going around the sun apparently. I brought in the white from the skirt with a white crossbody, but if you don't want to go with a yellow top, here's a white top that you can use instead. Now this is an actual cotton shirt, and I prefer to half-heartedly tuck it in so that I look cool, like I'm not trying, when in reality I spent way too much time trying to figure out what a half-hearted tuck looks like. If that's not your deal, you can always just tuck it in completely as well, but I just thought this looks kind of cool, you know? I don't know. This is what it looks like completely tucked in, and I'm still trying to act cool. I don't really know how to model, I'm just kind of going with it. See, look at that spin. Did that look professional? Did you see that? I fell down. Yo, can you smile a bit more? Maybe? I don't think she can hear me. I don't think she cares. Now this is the kind of skirt that I would wear most often in any kind of season. It adds a fit, it adds a flair, it adds a little bit of shape to my body. It cinches in a waist that I have and hides a bit of fat that I have too. And I mean, no shame in that. The best way to step up a look that comprises of a simple cotton skirt is by adding a shirt with a little bit of detail. Like this satin hemline and the cap sleeves are so cute and it just makes me so happy because I mean I dress up for myself, so these details, even if nobody else notices, just makes me, you know, have a little happy dance inside of me. Going from a cotton skirt to a polyester skirt. A polyester skirt tends to have a tighter waistline, which just causes your fat to bunch up a little bit. You can always rock that, but if you don't want to, you can just tuck in your shirt a little looser. Throw your shoulders back, be confident, and yeah, that's how you do it. But if that's not your deal, you can always just trade that out for a looser cotton skirt, shirt, looser cotton shirt. I decided to tuck this in just a little bit in the front, try out that Tan France tuck that works on every single Queer Eye episode. But I wanted to take full advantage of the waistband on this high-waisted skirt, so I tucked the shirt in completely. And that just really works better for me because, as I mentioned, I'm short. And as my brother mentions in every episode he's on, I'm short. So I just wanted to take advantage of the high-waisted silhouette. So this skirt is a lot tighter and it's really, really fancy. It just makes you feel kind of cool. This skirt used to be my mom's, so I mean, can we just give her a round of applause for how cool her style is, slash was, slash forever will be? Bodycon skirts just do something to you. They just make you want to, yeah, I mean, look at that. They just make you want to make everything look fancier. And yeah, I couldn't believe I did that either. I wanted to make this look even more formal, so I put on a button-down shirt. I left the bottom three buttons and I made sure to tuck it in starting from the back, putting that up and just tying a double knot. I then attempted to roll up the sleeves and please don't follow this as a step-by-step guide. I did a horrible, horrible job of this. Yeah, I mean, look at me. At least I'm transparent about my failures, if not my emotions. I went back to posing against the wall and I realized that this look was really formal, but it lacked one thing, a cool hairdo. So I tried to zhuzh up my quarantine bangs and make it look a little more presentable. Do you think I did it? Why does my bun look like a beret? It looks like I put a hat on my head that is made up of human hair. How creepy is that? It's probably creepier that I thought of it that way. I've just got a weird mind, what can I say? And then when I attempted to twirl around, the sleeves came out and I just gave up at that point. And wow, now you decide to laugh. You went an entire episode without laughing and it takes one outfit of you screwing up completely. Look at that turn. And there you go, another laugh. At least you're owning your mistakes. Growth, self-growth. Self-depreciation is part of it, guys. If you can do it, you've grown. I know a maxi dress is not a skirt, but if you can add a skirt to your wardrobe without actually buying one, why not? I added a shirt over this and then I tied it in with my hairband. You just have to ball it up in front, take out your hairband, tie a knot around it, and then tuck that part into your shirt, making sure to hide the hairband along with it. And ta-da! Look at that! It's so cute! The florals are so in. Groundbreaking, I know, right? And then I found this weird tassel and I was very confused about it, so I just kind of tucked it in and pretended it wasn't there. Whatever, it's for a photo, it's for a video. It's not like, you know, people are judging me. Oh, wait. Internet! Now, it would definitely be unfair of me to make an outfit video without including the outfit that I have worn consecutively for almost the entire summer. An Indian cotton skirt with an Indian kurta tucked in. That is the way to do it, man. This is what a summer outfit is. And just the fact that the colors are inverse of each other and that the skirt has a beautiful blue border and that the skirt's buttons somehow magically matches the shirt's buttons. Details. Details matter. You can always just not tuck in the kurta as well. And since this is a... Even if it was a full-length kurta, it would still work. I mean, Indians really know how to make cotton and indigo. It's just like, it's the perfect combination. With a little bit more awkward dancing later, and finally sitting down and saying that I'm done on 6 or 7 outfits, whatever it was, I really hope you enjoyed this video and you enjoy the outfits and that you can try it on just for yourself in the comforts of your bedroom. Or maybe you do venture out into the outside world. Tell me how it is. Bye!